Aleix Espargaró, how's he getting on? 11th at the moment. He's in soft tyre time attack mode as well, the Aprilia man.
Yeah, good lap as well, isn't it? Coming in from the number 41. This might put him in the top three or four of this session. Across the line for Aleix Espargaró. Yeah, fourth, 40.7. Now, Mir and Marquez will be coming through the final sector now. A really good lap coming in this from Alex Marquez.
Yeah, potentially a top five lap from the number 73. Dovizioso still down in 16th place in this session. Then here comes Alex Marquez now, just behind Joan Zarco. Is it going to be a top five lap? It is, it's a second. Great lap time that by Alex Marquez. Slowly but surely, that young man is working out what he needs to get the best out of that factory Honda. And we're starting to see another Marquez name edging towards the top of the MotoGP timesheets. He's third behind Taka Nakagami now. Two Hondas in the top three.
Yeah, we've not said that for a while, have we? Good to see that. Really good job from Alex Marquez. And another outstanding effort from Nakagami on the 2019 bike as well.
Yeah, because that's been his weak point, hasn't it, so far this year? It's been his big Achilles heel, Alex Marquez. Pace on soft tyres. In race trim, the guy has got, and he's shown so many times this year, top 10 pace.
Another rider who's found a massive chunk in terms of soft tyre attacks is the rookie Brad Binder, the Brno race winner. Here is the number 33. He's up by good margin in sector two.
Oh, well, it's took him a long time to figure out Barcelona on a MotoGP bike then, hasn't it?
Braking hard then into turn 10, and he's up again. This is going all the way to the top. We could be seeing the fastest time of the day so far here, coming from Brad Binder.
Good first sector as well by Cal Crutchlow. He's less than half a tenth down on the best first split of the session so far. Rins then overlying is fifth. What about Binder then? Deep now into that fourth sector. Ninth place right now for the South African on the Red Bull KTM machine.
Across the line then for Brad Binder. Where is this putting him? P1, 40.008. Brilliant time from Brad Binder. That's four tenths clear of anyone else.
Tech Skies was pretty happy with it. Binder top then. Simon Crafoord just saying there's a problem down in the pits for Fabio Quartararo. They're just trying to get that Yamaha fired up to get him out there late on in this session. Looking out of our commentary box window at the moment, doesn't look like it's happening at the moment, Simon, does it?
No, there's a problem there, big time. This is a good lap as well coming in from Rossi. Here is Fabio Quartararo then being told to get off the bike by his crew chief, Diego Grivellini. This will frustrate him a bit. Let's get Rossi over the line though. This could be a lap good enough for the top two or three here from Valentino. Over the line we come, and Aleix Espargaró again, sixth for Rossi.
It's a big advantage that Binder's got, isn't it? Over four tenths clear of Joan Mir. Paul Espargaró's gone ninth. Crutchlow 14th, 1:49 from Cal Crutchlow, within a second of the best time in his physical condition. Absolutely awesome. Second crash today, unfortunately, for Ika Lekuona. He was down at turn two this morning, FP1, and unfortunately, turn 12 has caught out the Spanish rookie now.
What a shame for Ika, just to halt his progress here today. Riders on good laps. The fastest lap, Brad Binder on the Red Bull KTM factory machine. Joan Zarco is up in sector two. Franco Morbidelli was up in sector two, but he's not far away in sector three. So Zarco is the next rider we need to be keeping an eye on here.
Will those guys be getting wave yellows though for the Lekuona incident?
Well, Morbidelli sat up and out of it, so perhaps he's decided to roll off on what looks like a really fast lap.
Can still see the yellow flag, Steve, being waved out of our commentary box window up at turn 12 where Lekuona crashed. Looks like those yellow flags, no, no, they are still waving, so it's obviously quite a big retrieval job at the moment going on for that KTMR C16.
Yeah, so this lap will be scrapped for Joan Zarco, and he backed off out of it anyway, which is good to see.
Yeah.
Paul Espargaró's lap as well. Yellow flags that have been removed, I think, so it's hard to know whether Paul Espargaró's time that's now coming in as he makes his way around the final sector will stand. We're now looking at the number 44. Brad Binder is in first. Are we about to see the factory KTM boys in P1 and P2 across the line? For now, no, not quite, but a good time nonetheless. 40.474 for Paul.
Vinales on a good lap, as is Franco Morbidelli. the two men who took the spoils in Misano's doubleheader. Quartararo, you can see there, just leaving pit lane. There is Maverick Vinales. This is going to be tight. This is going to be top three, surely, for Vinales. Yeah, estimated P3. Look at Morbidelli. What rhythm he's got. Zarco, too. The pair of them are out on brand new soft front and rear tyres. So this is a real electric pace being set by Franco Morbidelli. P1 beckoning as well for Zarco.
Cross the line with a checkered flag out. Quartararo won't get another lap in. Morbidelli coming into turn 10 then, 0.2 up. Vinales goes second, 40.2. Zarco's absolutely charging.
Zarco must be right behind Franco Morbidelli. You can just see their graphics and where they are in that fourth sector. And I thought Zarco's perhaps going to be a little bit closer to Morbidelli than what he is. Nakagami putting together a good lap. He's going to be okay in fourth place. There is Johann Zarco then. Is that going to be a session topping lap time coming in? Morbidelli's in the 39. Zarco goes second, so it will be
both in the 39s.
Franco Morbidelli, yeah, the first 39s we've seen of the day so far. Exchange between Morbidelli and Zarco. They used to exchange a bit of paintwork back in their motor 2 days, didn't they? A few good scraps, I remember, between that pair. So Morbidelli from Zarco. Binder will be inside the top three. Anybody else struggling that one? 39.789. Doesn't look like it's going to happen. Paul Espargaró. He's going to take the checkered flag and be at best seventh, which he'll be satisfied with.
Yeah, Cal Crutchlow is to come across the line and has improved to 12th with a 40.7, and that's your lot. Quartararo couldn't get a flying lap in. He'll be really miffed about that. It's just the sort of thing that will frustrate Fabio Quartararo. But no problems for Franco Morbidelli or Johann Zarco after that crash at turn 5.